Hello, this is the RPG Chick. Welcome back to Let's Play Lunar, Eternal Blue, Blind. Anyway, we explored the sewers some more. All I found was another chest with one holy water in it. We all went up a level. So here we are. Ian's a little behind and we need magic, but we're gonna go to the statue after this. What else? Everyone leveled? Yeah, we need to go buy stuff. Does Ramus have anything new to say? I'm showing sneak previews of my new Tunnels of Carnage attraction. We've converted the Meribian sewers. It's gonna be great. You can convert anything. We're all gonna die. I think Junior is gonna kick me out of this place. He's mad they made that big hole in the wall. Yeah, I've seen that. That's that. Rejuvenated! Anyway. Not impressed. Right, some kind of robe. To replace the aura dress. It was a graceful dress, I think. Oh no, the judgment robe. So the graceful dress is better for her. Alright. Judgment robe. Defense goes up by 3, wisdom goes up by 8. Magic endurance goes down, unfortunately, by 5. But sold. And of course, we'll just sell the old one. For 1,000. Yeah, no, we're done. No more again. Ye item shoppy. So we have the money. Starlights. Three, four, five, six, seven, eight, nine, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15. Hey, they only give you back 30 magic points. Now I just want to check in on Master Lun. And then we'll get going on our way. Oh, this way. Just want to see if he has anything new to say. About this guy. Lun travels all over the place. He goes to Pentagulia to meet with the goddess. Then he goes to Horam to check on that city, and then back here to Meribia. Not sure whether or not we've seen him say that before. Doesn't seem familiar. Master Lun's karate draws on the teachings of several different styles. He's trying to develop the most powerful karate ever known to man. Don't let his quest for power fool you. He's really got a big heart. The last time I checked, Lun was in there, but then again, he's been known to sneak out of here quietly, if you get my drift. Oh, like a ninja? Lun won't be back for a long time. The goddess Althena made a request that he go to Pentagulia. I'm sure he won't be back until he's solved that little problem. If something is troubling you, my child, you can discuss it with me. But don't worry, as a priest, I cannot tell anyone what you've told me. I don't have the option of actually replying to you. Okay, so now we have to go back. Once we've rescued all the kiddos, we have to go back to Taben's Peak. Come one, come all, try out Ramus's latest wonder, the Tunnels of Carnage. This action-packed thrill ride will put you face-to-face with death itself. Only you decide the final outcome. All the monsters are real. Yeah, sounds great. Oh, I love this song. It's not gonna last long, though. I'm about to be attacked by something. We'll go in here. A little ditty. Still blocking our path. Just for the hell of that. What? You again? I suppose you want another ride up? That would be nice. Okay, everyone on board. Here we go. It's interesting how he squished into one little figure like that and then turned into this train as soon as he moved. That is a funny line. Alright, let's go see how these kids are doing. Oh! Nal says, I'm very impressed. You rescued all the kidnapped dragon kids. To tell you the truth, I thought they were all goners. Ruby says, eh, it was nothing. Hero's a master of strategy, and we have a great team. Do you think this kind of adventuring is appropriate for a red dragon? Red dragon? But I didn't say anything about being a red dragon. That's because the one we're talking to is a white dragon. You didn't have to. Believe me, I can tell. How? How can you tell? And what do you mean, not appropriate? Tell me this instant. Instant. I think you all had better come inside. I've got something to tell you. Do it in an anime cutscene. Or not. Hey everybody, look. Hero and his party are back. How about some applause? We don't know how to thank you enough for rescuing our friends. You must be very powerful to have defeated the Blue Dragon cult. There was only one guy and he ran away. I'd like to hear the story of how you did it. Will you tell it? Nal says, okay, that's enough. I'm sure they don't want to tell bedtime stories. You've expressed your thanks, so leave the good people alone now. Hero, you said you wanted to know where Lucia was. I saw her around here a while ago. If you look hard, you should find her. What happened? The other two aren't coming with us. Well, we'll find out what's up with them in a second. I shudder to think what would have happened to us if you hadn't come along. If Nal doesn't show us a full appreciation for what you did for him, just chalk it up to him being Nal. Well, I can't talk today. He doesn't always show what he feels. Hey kids, let's play Pin the Cash on Lamina, okay? It's really fun. You just try to pin as much cash on me as you can. So break your piggy banks. I want to get this game started. Do any of you little squirts want to be magicians when you grow up? Well, study hard, and maybe you'll be strong enough to enter the Vain Magic Guild. By the time you grow up, it'll be fully restored. I bet you I know where she is. She's in that, like, garden out back, or that courtyard, or whatever it is. I don't know how to thank you all for saving my friends. By saying thank you. Now that everyone's been rescued, we're getting ready to take down the barricades. We should be done shortly. If you wait just a little longer, the barricades will be cleared from the road. Then you can get to Vane. Sweet. Juanfo says, "Hey there, Chief. Have you found Lucia yet? I heard she's looking for you." Ruby says, "We haven't seen her yet. Do you know where she is?" "Not a clue, Buckaroo. I just know she's around here somewhere. Go find her." "What's the matter? Don't you want to find Lucia? She was asking for you, you know. If that were you, I'd go find her." "Thank you for rescuing me from the evil blue dragon cult. Know what, huh? Wanna know what? When I grow up, I'm gonna be just like you." "Lucia's around here somewhere. Try upstairs." "I always knew that someone would rescue me from the blue dragon cult. That's why I wasn't scared, but I never guessed Nal wouldn't be with them. When I grow up, I want to be Nal's bride. Tee-hee-hee." Ruby says, "I don't think you know everything you need. I don't think you know everything you need to about your dream cake. I'm certain he has some dark secrets." He's another flying dragon, but I don't know what happened. He changed into some human form or something. "Ha! Ha! Yeah! Come on over and play with us." "No, you're weird. You're my second favorite heroes in the whole world. Nal's my favorite." Jean says, "Watching these kids play reminds me of my childhood. But luckily, they'll never have to endure the horror of the Blue Dragon Cult. That's a chapter of my life I wish I could erase." "Everyone here is my best friend. I'm so glad they came back. I'm so glad everyone is now safe and sound. Oh, except Gimpy John, but he wasn't sound to begin with." "Gimpy John. I don't know how to thank you guys properly. You've done so much." Alright, so we gotta check upstairs. We just look around here. No. Okay. Hi, seen Lucia? Lucia's getting this song and dance thing down. I saw her doing some moves that make me want to scream. Really? Lucia is just like us. She was abandoned and left all alone on the Blue Star. We've adopted her and made her an honorary member of the Lostest Boys. Hey, I got the best luck in the world. I was saved from the cult, and I get a hot babe to watch over me. What a life. Hey, big boy, have you kissed Lucia yet? Come on, you can tell me. Oh, you have. Your red face proves it. Ruby says, "Why don't you look for sleaze somewhere else?" Sleaze, huh? Lucia has really been there for me the last couple of days. When I was scared and crying last night, Lucia came in and sang me to sleep. I wish that I had a mother that cared for me the way she does. Alright. Well, she's not in here. Yes, life is so great now that all my friends have returned home. Thank you for helping us. Now that you've rescued the kids, Nal said we can play anywhere we want. It's starting to be like old times since all my friends have returned. Jean is the only grown-up besides Nal that has never lied to me. I'm strong enough to fight the cult. Take me with you. I'll crush them. Nah, it's okay. I gave it the office. Ah, the throne. It feels good. She's got to be in that back area, which is along this wall back here, I believe. Wait, that's not it. It's further this way. Why'd that scare me? Good luck trying to get into the spring. Lucia's taking forever. We're not going to wait for her to finish. Girls, they're so dumb. Ooh, can we see Lucia bathing in the spring? Goody goody. Ooh, that's her clothes. Oh, she knows the song. Oh, she's just humming it too. Unfortunately, I cannot sing like that. I can't move.
Who's there?
Now, why would she care? She was like walking naked among them when it was, she was changing into that other outfit. What's his name? Hero is like, humana, humana, humana. Ruby says, Hero, don't look. Turn around. No, you idiot. This is the best time to not turn around. Hero, please wait for me outside. This is outside. This is inside. You're outside. Hero, hello? Hero, you can blink now. I just can't believe you're acting like you did at the carnival. Jeez, Hero, you really need to go take a cold shower. Lucia says, Hero, I... Awesome. Ruby says, come on, you two. Enough with the goo-goo eyes already. Let's get a move on. Everyone is waiting for us. Alright. But... That's it? The cutscene was, like, 2 seconds long. Alright. Ronfor says, hey, Chief, you found Lucia. Say, why do both of you look like you're blushing? Blushing? Lucia asks. Jean says, it means your face is red and hot because you're embarrassed. Embarrassed. I can't talk. Lamina says, I bet Hero was putting the mega moves on her. Right, Lucia? Oh, not exactly. This blushing is quite uncomfortable. Anything new to say. Best friend? What? Why'd she react like that? Lucia says, I would like to learn how to play, but I do not have the time now. Okay, so now we got Lucia responding to this stuff, so maybe I'll come back later and you can teach me. Jean says, the best thanks you can give me is to grow up to be a good person. Oh, now saying, hey, wait up. We weren't gonna leave yet, I'm just talking to people. I heard you were headed to Pentagulia to find the goddess Althina. Before you left, I wanted to give you something as thanks for all your help. How about your... clue behind your real identity? Oh, we got white dragon wings from now. I think you'll find these are a real kick. They've lost a bit of power in the last half century, but they can still warp you out of any dungeon back to the ground level. They work pretty well most of the time. I hope they serve you well. What are we going to do with all these dragonfly wings then? Could either sell them or just use them one by one. The barricade on the road to Vane is now open. Good luck on your quest. Alright, we weren't done talking to these people. I've seen this one. Why are you hanging around here? Don't you have more important things to do? I mean, I know my hideout is cool, but you better hit the road. Ruby says, we're going. I hope we run into this Nahl again and see him, like, transform into the winged dragon. Alright, let's go. See ya. Barricade is gone. Lumina says, we're almost to Vane. Aren't you excited? Now, I want to warn you that the city might look a little run down at first glance, but once we get the guild back up and running, the town will be ship-shape in no time. All it takes is a little elbow grease. Ruby says, yeah, and a lot of cash. How much are you planning on draining us for? Oh, poo, Ruby. You always take something good and see the bad in it. Can't we just enjoy the moment for what it is? Sure. As long as it's free. Okay, we're through. Now, I'm not sure where Vane is, which way we're supposed to go. South or east? Oh, these flies again. Killer wasp, sorry. Well, it's nice to have Lucia back again for like the third time or something. Plasma rain on this one little fly. It's already damaged, I think. Oh my god. Well, that's a bit of overkill. I don't know if we're supposed to be going this way. This plasma rain all the time on one poor little wasp. It's pretty impressive though, I gotta admit. So far we're completely undamaged. But I can't go that way. Looks like I can go that way, doesn't it? Back up around this way. Forget it, these fatal hoppers harder? I think they... I'm not sure. Lightning bomb. Okay, up and around. we can't go anywhere there. Let's check out this way. Oh! Is this Vein? Someone's saying Lamina. I guess it is Vein. Oh, Lamina! Thank Althina, you've come back. We're in big trouble. Big trouble? What are you talking about? Did you lose your purse again? No, no, no. Borgin has come to Vein. Borgin? You mean that big, fat, evil? Yes, that Borgin. He said he wanted to talk with your mother, Miria. We tried to stop him and the party of magicians he bought. I like the way she says that, like she doesn't know who her mother is. Oh, Miria, that's one. We tried to stop him and the party of magicians he brought, but they were just too strong. They stormed the guild mansion. Oh no, mother, we've got to get over there. Servants of the Most High Master Borgin, we cannot allow anyone to enter Vein. Borgin has decreed that no one shall enter until he completes his business. Well, what business is he doing? Number one or number two? Get out of my way, you morons. Halt! Who are you? You don't know who I am? Now I know you really are simpletons. I am Lamina, Junior Premier of the Magic Guild of Vein. Now, if you'd be so kind as to get your mega scrawny butts out of my way. We don't care if you're Althina herself. Borgin has decreed that none shall enter, and we are here to enforce that edict. Step back, girl. I know much more about Vein than you ever will. I'll find a way to get in. And when I do, I'm gonna make sure you're sorry, Buster. Hey guys, listen up. To the east of here, there's a transmission spring, so I remember it. If it works, we can use it to enter Vein behind their backs. Come on, I know this is going to work. Let's get going. Hero, it's really very safe, I promise. Halt! Step back. By order of Master Borgin, no one is to enter Vein. By order of Lamina, I command you to stand there and look like dorks. Ha! Look at that, they're doing it. Haha. Forget this, we can sneak in from the transmission spring. It's located to the east of here, let's go. Grandmaster Borgin insists that we cannot argue while in Vein. He respects the sanctity and rich tradition of this place. Borgin is a showman and a liar. He respects nothing but his own belly. If he's hurt my mother, I'll gut him with a paper cutter and a spoon. We can't talk to this lady, can we? No. The east of here. Well, thanks for watching. Let's tune back next time when we go to the east of here to find the transmission spring. See you next time, and a bang bang boogie, and don't stop the boogie.